Hello everyone, I am Bob and this is the Home Bitcoin Immersion Mining channel. In this design series episode, we're going to cover heating your house with Bitcoin. So with that, let's get started. Okay, so these are the episodes I've been looking forward to, and I hope you have been too. And that's because the focus of this next series of episodes is how to heat your house using the heat from your Bitcoin miners. Now, there are a number of different ways to do this, and the method you choose will depend on a couple different factors. First, and most important, how's your house heated? Does your house have air ducting and vents and is heated by forced air? Or does your house have water pipes and radiators and is heated by a hydronic or hot water system? Second, how do you want to run your Bitcoin miners? Do you want to only run your miners when you can use that heat to heat your house? Or do you want to keep your miners running all the time and divert that heat to your house only when it is needed? Now, when it comes to how your home is heated, you don't have much of a choice here. Unless you are looking to build a new house or make drastic changes to your current house, you're kind of stuck with what you have. So the answer to that first question is pretty straightforward. However, when it comes to the second question of how you want to run your miners, this is really up to you. Maybe your goal is to focus on efficient use of your miner power, where you only want to run your miner when you can use that energy to heat your house. This is a good strategy if you are using old, inefficient miners, or if you want to maximize the return on the cost of the electricity you are using in your mining. Alternatively, maybe your goal is to mine as much Bitcoin as you can, where you want to keep your miners running nonstop and just redirect the heat to your house only when it is needed. This is a good strategy if you have cheap or subsidized power or really efficient miners. Now, the answers to these two questions result in four different types of home heating setups. All four will work just fine, but there are some different design steps to take for each one, and you have to narrow this down to a single setup before you design and build your system. In the next several episodes, I'm going to walk through each of these different types in depth and give you the information you need to know to design and build your home Bitcoin heating system. But before getting into these design episodes, I want to cover what to expect when you change your heating system over to Bitcoin heating. Now, if your house is currently heated by a hydronic or hot water system, your Bitcoin home heating will likely be very similar to what you experience now. However, if your house is currently heated by a forced air system, things are going to be a little different with Bitcoin heating. A typical forced air furnace size is somewhere in the range from, say, 60,000 to 120,000 BTU. In contrast, a home Bitcoin immersion mining system running two S19 miners will generate 6 to 8 kilowatts of heat, depending on overclocking, and that is equivalent to roughly 27,000 BTU, which is a lot less than a typical furnace. So how is this going to work? Well, the typical forced air furnace turns on and blasts out hot air at somewhere between 105 and 135 degrees Fahrenheit. It does this for a short period of time until your home gets up to temperature and then shuts off. If your furnace is sized correctly for your climate, it will run 10 to 15 minutes per cycle and 2 to 3 cycles per hour on your coldest day. On an average or warm winter day, your furnace will be running much less often and for shorter times. So although your furnace might be rated at 60 to 120,000 BTU, you're actually only using an average of, say, 30 to 60,000 BTU on a cold day and much less than that on an average or warm winter day. And so if your Bitcoin heater is running nonstop at, say, 27,000 BTU, it will have plenty of heat to keep your house warm on mild to average winter days. However, on the coldest of days, a two-miner setup might struggle a little, and that's why it's important that your existing furnace is still available as a backup. And I'll cover how to make that work in the upcoming episodes. Now, this is going to change how you experience your home heating. Instead of a hot air blast that turns on and off throughout the day, causing the temperature of your house to fluctuate up and down, Bitcoin heating is going to be much more even and steady. The heat coming out of your registers is going to be only a little hotter than the ambient air, maybe even less than 80 degrees Fahrenheit. Also, your furnace fan will likely stay on for most of the day. And so the heat in your house will be much more constant and not fluctuate as much. And this might make for a more comfortable home. And there are a couple other really cool benefits you'll get here too. Because your fan is on for most of the day, you'll see less wear and tear on your HVAC system since the fan is not going through as many start and stop cycles, which can wear out your equipment. Also, this will circulate more air through your home filtration system, reducing dust, allergens, and other contaminants in your air. So after switching, you might find you like Bitcoin heating more than your old furnace. Okay, so that's all I have for this episode. With that introduction out of the way, in the next few episodes, I'm going to start walking through the detailed information you need to heat your house with Bitcoin. So with that, bye.